We are here with one of the biggest boxing experts on the planet, Dougie Fischer, Ring Magazine. Your dad's a big expert, you know that, right?
Yeah.
See, even your dog.
Not according to YouTube comments, but that's all good. Keep saying it.
What do you think? What does Doug Fischer's gut say? Mayweather Pacquiao or Cotto Canelo? Which one are we turning on the TV on May 2nd?
I'm going to go with Cotto Canelo. I think there's just less obstacles in that mega matchup. Obviously, Mayweather Pacquiao is the biggest fight that can be made in boxing. That's the fight that people outside of boxing know about and ask about all the time. Cotto Canelo, it's a huge event because of the history between Mexican and Puerto Rican fighters. And of course, the statures of Cotto and Canelo. Cotto is the first ballot Hall of Famer Puerto Rican star. Canelo's the biggest Mexican star out there right now. And you combine them, you're going to get attention from the mainstream, but not like Mayweather Pacquiao. That's like just global. But unfortunately, there's the network issues. There's the promoter, manager issues, the Bob Arum, Al Haymon clashing of the heads. There's the egos of the fighters themselves. Hey, Mayweather's got a big ego, and you know, Pacquiao, a humble dude, person to person, but he's got his pride as well. He's not going to be totally dictated to. He's not going to be treated like a B-side. You know, there's an A-side and there's always a B-side. In this fight, there's an A-side and an A-minus side.
Pacquiao, who's the A?
Floyd is the A-side. Floyd's the champ. Floyd's the undefeated guy. Floyd's the guy who's got the better pay-per-view numbers in recent years. So, I mean, he's got a little bit more weight at the negotiating table, but it's not like he can just... It's not like he's dealing with Robert Guerrero or Victor Ortiz or even a Shane Mosley. You know what I'm saying? Pacquiao brings a lot to the table. He brings the biggest fan base anybody can bring to the fight, even more so than Canelo brought last September. So he's got to be treated with some respect, and I think that's kind of hard for the money team to treat people like equals. So I don't know. I just, my gut feeling says there's just too many obstacles with that. I'm not saying it's impossible, but I just say there's a lot less obstacles for Cotto and Canelo to be made. You know, there's the X factor, and that's the Mayweather Cotto rematch being made. I guess that's another discussion.
Who wins Cotto Canelo? Who wins Mayweather Pacquiao?
I like Canelo in the Cotto fight. It's a dangerous. It's a good competitive fight, and it's an exciting fight given their styles and given their mentalities, and given the pressure that their national followings are going to be putting on them to really not just go in there and win, but get in there and represent. There you go. Yeah, represent. Yeah. But I just think Canelo's a real middleweight, and I don't think Cotto's a real middleweight. I think Cotto was kind of pushing it at junior middleweight. I think his form and his confidence is sky high with Freddie Roach. But his last two fights, there's some matchmaking involved in the form.
Absolutely. Devin Rodriguez, ranked 17th.
Right.
Sergio, one leg, one arm,
Sergio,
one knee.
I've never seen a guy whose legs. Now, you got to give Cotto credit because he clipped him hard in that first round and really what little legs he brought in there, he knocked him out. So he had a guy who was on the edge and he pushed him over. But still, it took him like 9 rounds to finish the job, and eventually it was the corner that stopped him. It wasn't a cold knockout that Cotto scored. I think Canelo's gonna put hands on him and he's gonna feel his age. He's gonna get busted up. But Canelo's gonna get busted up too. I just think he's young and big and strong enough to where he could take that beating and suck it up and dish it back. And I think just eventually it's either a late stoppage for Canelo or a decision, a close competitive decision win.
I think
Cotto gets the worst of that.
I agree with you 100%.
Do you?
And
okay.
I'm not a hater. I just call it like I see it.
Yeah, yeah.
Although now 1,000 comments. How about this, Doug?
Yeah.
Floyd Mayweather, Manny Pacquiao.
Man, you know what? I don't know about that fight. You know, when we first started talking about it in late 2009, 2010, I loved Manny Pacquiao in the fight. He was just too dynamic, too fast, too strong, too all over the place, too busy. You know, the guy that was throwing, averaging 100 punches a round against Josh Clotty, I just couldn't see Mayweather defending against that. I'm not saying Mayweather wouldn't have got his licks in or couldn't go the distance. I just couldn't see him outpointing that fighter. But 2011, 2012, Pacquiao slowed down. And, of course, at the end of 2012, he got KTFO against Juan Marquez, and I was thinking he was done. And really, even after the Brandon Rios fight, which in retrospect, Manny looked pretty good in that fight. You know, I mean, he outclassed the young man. But I didn't think he was an elite fighter anymore. But after last year, after the way he looked against Timmy Bradley in their rematch, and the way he looked against Chris Algieri, these two young guys, one of them, everybody ranked like number three pound for pound, Tim Bradley. Everybody.
Yeah, but
everybody had him behind Mayweather and Ward, and Manny Pacquiao beat him soundly.
But what about their punching power, those two opponents?
Yeah, they're not punchers, but neither is Mayweather. Maybe Mayweather gets a little bit harder than them, but is Mayweather as active as they are? Does Mayweather move around the way they do? Is Mayweather as tough as Bradley and Chris Algieri? Is he willing? And I'm not saying he's not tough, because I think one of his underrated qualities, along with his physical strength and his punching power, is his durability. But is he willing to take the kind of beatings that a Tim Bradley and a Chris Algieri will take?
He fought Maidana twice. He fought Maidana twice. Maidana does punch hard, trust me.
He did. And you know what? Maidana extended him in both fights.